In this section, I want to talk about segment routing mechanism. In other words, control plane and data plane process in segment routing. As you remember, in the first video of segment routing, definition of segment routing, the segment routing network is a network where the traffic route is inserted into the packet itself. That means when a packet arrives at the edge of the network, we can determine the path of the traffic based on our policy and the quality of service requirement of the traffic, and then add that path to the traffic or packet itself. By edge of the network, I mean access switches in the LAN and data center network where receive the traffic from server or host, and PE routers in the service provider network which receive customer traffic. How do we add the path of traffic in the packet itself? As we have seen, we add the ID of routers or ID of the links through which the packet should be transmitted into the packet itself. In other words, we add the segments over which the packet is to be transmitted into the packet itself. We have two types of segments. Prefix SID or ID of the router, another name for ID of the router, and adjacency SID or ID of the link, another name for ID of the link. In summary, when a packet arrives at the edge of the network, first determine the path based on our policy and packet quality of service requirement. Then we add prefix SID or adjacency SID of the path in the packet itself. Then the packet is routed to the destination, but through the path that we have already inserted into the packet. We know that the goal of segment routing is traffic engineering. This means that we control the path of traffic at the edge of the network based on our policy and traffic quality of service requirement. Some traffic need high bandwidth, some traffic need, like voice, need minimum delay. But if we don't define a policy for our traffic, the traffic path would be the same as IGP path. In other words, when we don't define a policy in segment routing network, segment routing path should be the same with IGP path. This is also true for MPLS network. When there is no policy in MPLS network, MPLS path and IGP path are the same. In order to better understand the default process of segment routing, consider that this topology that the routers XRV1, XRV2, XRV4, XRV5, and XRV6 are connected sequentially. XRV1 and XRV6 are the edge of the network. If the traffic is received in XRV1, whose destination is XRV6, or is sent to a destination where the next hop router is XRV6, then router XRV insert the ID of the router XRV6 or prefix SID of XRV6. This is the packet. The destination is XRV6 or the next hop is XRV6. Then it add the prefix SID of XRV6, or we add a segment into the packet itself, assuming the network is a segment routing network. Then XRV1 asks itself, how can I route the traffic to XRV6? Because the segment inside the packet shows that the packet should be routed to XRV6. It decides based on the best IGP path and then forward the packet to XRV2. When XRV2 receives the traffic, the same traffic, the segment XRV6, it sees that the segment of XRV6 has already been added to the packet. That means the packet should be forwarded to X86. How can I forward that packet to X86? XRV2 asks itself. It decides based on the best origin pass and forward packet to XRV4. But before forwarding to XRV4, it swaps the label or the segment XRV6 with XRV6. Yes, you are right. It swaps the label XRV6 with itself or with XRV6. Why XRV2 swaps the label with itself? Because with MPLS network, we have three main actions. Pop, to remove the top label. Push, to insert a new label. And swap, to change the label. Pop, push, and swap. These are MPLS actions. In this scenario, it swaps the label, but the incoming label and the outgoing label are the same. In router XRV4, the same process is repeated. XRV6 label is swapped with the same label. But in XRV5, it is different since it is the last router before destination or penultimate router. And because of PHP rule or penultimate hop-popping rule in MPLS, it pops the label from incoming packet and then forward the packet. We assume that you know PHP mechanism and we don't talk about it here. Just know that the router before the last router pop the label and forward the packet without any label to XRV6. So this is the data plane process in the segment routing network when there is no policy defined at the edge of the network. In this process, each router chooses a prefix SID for itself, which is unique globally through the network. For example, router XRV6 chooses prefix SID 16006 for its loopback interface and advertise it through OSPF and ISS to all other routers in the network. Or XRV5 chooses 16005 as its prefix ID, and the same is true for other routers. Notice that there is no LDP protocol to advertise prefix ID or labels, but the labels are advertised through OSPF and ISIS extension. In addition to prefix SID, each router choose an ID for each of its directly connected links called adjacency SID, which is locally significant. For example, router XRV5 has two direct links and choose an adjacency SID for each of its links, which is locally significant. For example, 24001 and 24002. I'll repeat again that the prefix SID is globally unique and we will configure it manually. But adjacency SID is locally significant and it is generated dynamically. Prefix SID is globally unique. It means that if a router, for example, XRV6, select 16006, has a prefix SID, the other routers cannot use the same prefix SID. Both prefix SID and adjacency SID are advertised through OSPF or ISIS in the network, and so all routers know each other's prefix SID and adjacency SID. This allows the routers to include the interesting path in the packet based on a mixture of prefix SID and adjacency SID. To better understand the control plane and data plane process of segment routing, I've already implemented a similar topology. As you can see, every router has a loopback interface with IP address, for example, 1.1.1.1.2.2.2.2 and so on, according to their router number 1, 2, 4, 5, or 6. The IP address of each link is selected also based on the router number. For example, 10.2.4 for the connection between router number 2 and number 4. And the address 10.4.5 is for the connection between router 5 and router 4 and router 5. And the last digit is also the number of the router. The configuration is done in 3 steps. 1, IP addressing of loopback and Ethernet interface. IP address of the loopback and Ethernet interface. IP address of loopback and 2 Ethernet interface. Then, enable ISIS level 2 in all routers and all links. For example, ISIS type level 2 only, the net ID is here 1, here 2, and also 3, also 4, 5, and 6 for the other routers. And the most important section is to enable segment routing in ISIS. As you see, we don't need any other control plane protocol like LDP. For configuring segment routing, metric stall wide is required to enable segment routing in ISIS. And metric stall wide. And then segment routing with MPLS is activated. In segment routing, there are two options for data plane, MPLS and IP version 6. In this section, we are talking about MPLS version of segment routing and not IPv6. Then we choose a prefix SID for every router which have to be globally unique in the network. For example, 16001 for router XRV1, 16002 for XRV2, and so on, and 16006 for XRV6. The prefix SID range by default is between 16,000 and 23,999, and also changeable. We can change this global range. Prefix SID can be configured as an index or as an absolute amount. Here I have configured as an absolute amount, but it can be configured as an index. Index 1 means 16,001. Index 2 means 16,002. Index 10 means 16,010. Contrary to prefix SID, adjacency SID is assigned dynamically and they are locally significant and not need to be configured. Both prefix SID and adjacency SID are advertised through IGP. Again, to better understand the segment routing mechanism, let's first review the configuration in a real environment and then review the control plane and data plane process of our scenario. First, we review the configuration commands in XRV1, for example, admin raiko-co.com, with show IP interface brief. You can check the IP address. In XRV1, the loopback interface is 1111, and the gigabit Ethernet 0 is 1012 for the connection between router 1 and router 2, and 1 is the number of the router, the last digit of the IP address. With show running config router ISIS, I can check the configuration of ISIS and also segment routing. Router ISIS lab level 2 net ID, address family IPv4 is enabled for ISIS, metric install wide, and segment routing with data plane MPLS. For the interface loopback, prefix SID, index is 1, that means the prefix SID is 16001. And also Giga Ethernet 0 is enabled in ISIS in addition to loopback 0. Now that we have seen the configuration, let's look at the segment routing data plane process. First data plane and then control plane. When IP traffic in XRV1 is received at the edge of network with a destination or the next hop of XRV6, safe table in XRV1 is processed to find out the outgoing interface and also outgoing label. With show safe 666 /32, I can check safe table in XRV1 for the destination XRV6 or for the next hop XRV6. As you can see, the next hop is 10122, which is the router number 2, and the label which should be imposed into the packet is segment number 16006, which is the prefix SID of router 6, XRV6. The output of safe table shows that the packet must be forwarded to the router XRV2, and the label 16006 will be pushed to the packet. Packet with label 16006 is received in router XRV2. So the LFIB table in XRV2 is processed to find out the outgoing interface and the outgoing label, since the incoming traffic is MPLS packet. When incoming traffic is IP packet, the safe table is processed. When the incoming traffic is label packet, LFIB table is processed. So in router 2, with command show MPLS forwarding table, we can check LFIB table. As you can see, for the label, incoming label, for the incoming label 16006, the outgoing label is also 16006, and the packet needs to be forwarded to XRV4. The same output can be seen in XRV4. Let's check it. Show MPLS forwarding table, incoming label and outgoing label for 16006 are the same. But in XRV5, when the packet with label 16006 is received, the situation is different. Let's check it. Show MPLS forwarding. As you can see, the label is popped due to PHP or penultimate hop popping rule in MPLS, and packet without label will be forwarded to router XRV6. This is exact the same that we have already talked about. In show MPLS forwarding output, you can also see how much traffic is forwarded with each label to make sure in router XRV1 I send some traffic to router XRV6, for example, ping 6.6, to check if the amount of traffic is updated in XRV5 or not. Now it's 12,500, and then now it is 13,500. Now let's look at segment routing control plane process. As you know, in control plane, every router assign an adjacency SID for each of its links dynamically, which is locally significant. In addition to that, we assign a prefix SID for loopback interface of every router manually, which we have already configured. Prefix SID and adjacency SID both are advertised through OSPF or ISIS in the network. For example, let's check adjacency SID of router links connected to router XRV5 and then check the ISIS database in router XRV1 to make sure that these adjacency SID and prefix SID of XRV5 are advertised and received in XRV1. We can check the adjacency SID assigned for each link. We have got two link connected to router 4 and link connected to router 6. As you can see, there are two labels assigned to each link dynamically. And the dynamic labels started with 24,000 because up to 23,999 is reserved for prefix SID. Protected and non-protected labels are assigned for each link. For now, we ignore protected adjacency SID since we have not still discussed about protection in segment routing network. In the next videos, we will discuss also protection in segment routing. Here also, non-protected adjacency is 24,003 and 24,001. These two are non-protected adjacency SID or labels. And now in XRV1, we show ISIS database verbose XRV5. We make sure that the adjacency SID and also prefix SID related to router XRV5 are received in XRV1. As you can see, prefix SID related to XRV5 is index 5 or 16,005, and adjacency SID are 24,003 and 24,001, as we have already seen.